let's read 1 Corinthians 2, verse 9.
Bafurinta ba pele chapter 2, riyamolawo verse 9.
If we want to reach where we know God.
Harinyoko tseba sfita siyamong sa utseba modimo.
And know his thoughts.
Ritsebele mehopolo ya hai.
We must learn to judge our thoughts.
Ari tutengo hatula ya rena mehopolo.
But look here.
Libelela.
If we start to put in our thoughts the things of God.
Ari chomo beya mehopolo ya rena dilo tsa modimo.
We invite the Holy Spirit.
Re mema moyo mogetwa.
To find what we put there. Because the Spirit of God searches even the deep things. Not just deep things, but of God. If we try to put right thing, right thoughts, and we're able to remove wrong thoughts, if we make our thoughts his thoughts, we will always deal with the Holy Spirit. We can be able to please God by our lives because every action we show is coming from our thoughts. Ephesians 4. Verse 17. People around us can affect our thoughts. We end up living like them. And such people are alienated from the love of God, from the presence of God. If we know that God wants us to stay in his presence, we will deal with our thoughts. Our thoughts are so important that they can betray us if we don't judge them. If we just try to conclude everything as if everything is from God, we can be failures. Like if your thoughts are his thoughts. If truly your thoughts will be his thoughts, your way will be his way. Luke 7.
Verse 36 to 50. Because
thoughts makes you to communicate to
yourself.
I can say this to you. If you take the word of God to be your thoughts, and you begin to think about them, the word,
to yourself,
we call it meditation. You don't judge your thoughts. You can end up fighting against God. We have got many people around us who are looking at you when you are doing something. When other people are serving God, when you look at them, you begin to have thoughts. Be careful of those thoughts. Because some people are doing what you cannot do because they know where they come from. Always, all the time, our thoughts mislead us. Especially when we are in a position which is better than others. We look at others, we rectify them. Speak to ourselves in a wrong way than to accept what they are doing. Remember, the Spirit of God searches. It searches deep and found your thought. What you think it cannot be hidden is exposed already before God. We need to be very careful about what we are thinking about other people. Because when the Spirit of God is there, it searches everything. Why you are rejected? Why you are accepted? It's because of your thoughts. Matthew 9:19. The way you are today, it came from your thoughts. Your faith is coming from your thoughts. For you to be blessed today, check your thoughts. Thoughts are so powerful that they can be considered faith. Not from here, from where you come from.
Can you just
start from thoughts? If you're a strong Christian, it starts from thoughts. If we are able to turn our thoughts to be His thoughts, God will be with us always. Because when the Spirit of God began to search for that thought, there will be a reward. Can I tell you why we are not receiving anything? It's because when the Spirit of God searches our thoughts, they don't find any faith. There's no faith. There have to be something that you build it up. You are telling yourself, you are not telling other people. This week, I will receive something. This become your thought. It's not something that is happening outside. It's contrary to what is happening around. What is happening around is opposite to what you are thinking. Therefore, your solution is not determined by the outside. It's determined by the inside. When you are carrying on with the right thoughts, God will look and address that thought. Can you see thoughts? People are singing voices out. Shouting as if something is happening. God looks inside you. Matthew 5, verse 28. We are in danger today if we are not able to deal with our eyes. Because wherever you direct your eyes, that's where you establish your thoughts. When you are directing your eyes to the north, even your thoughts are there. What directs your eyes is your thoughts. What is really affecting us is our thoughts. If our thoughts are in righteousness, there's no way God won't direct us. If we clean up our thoughts, what will happen is now, the Holy Spirit will be able to direct our eyes. The reasons why Holy Spirit is not directing our eyes, it's because our thoughts are empty. We have to see what we are seeing. How do you tolerate to see sin until it is completed? It means you have entertained that from your own thoughts. So Jesus said, that person is already. Allow the word of God to be in your thoughts, so that the Spirit of God that searches even the deep thing will find that weight. And when the word of God is found in you, the word of God produces power. It produces results. It produces victory. What will be addressed by Jesus? It is the thought you have established. Tell me, what will be addressed by Jesus? It is the thought you have established. Ephesians 3, verse 20. Prayer and thinking is one thing. Your thoughts are prayers. Your thoughts brings out your lifestyle. If you believe, say amen. If your thoughts are not cleansed, sanctified, there is nothing you receive from God. I'm telling you, you need to deal with yourself. Do you know why Satan is trying to attack you? So that you must remove what you put in your mind. You must say, I'm defeated.
Oh,
oh, I'm about to die. Oh, oh, things are tough. Oh, hey. Remind
Satan
what you put in your mind. And the Holy Spirit will take that and show it to Jesus. I don't know if you're hearing me. I don't know if you're hearing me. Today, something is going to be revealed in you, and it will come to pass in your life. If you believe, say amen. When now you see that, you look like you are empty.
Is
Satan talking?
Satan,
because Satan always talks in your thoughts. You are empty.
When
you are defeated. You cannot be used by God. You are going nowhere. You are poor. You are going to die. Now you tell the devil what the Bible says, which you put in your mind, that has become your thought.
And
say, devil, I always think, and I'm still thinking, and I have what I think, because you are able to do above what I think. I know I'm feeling, but because you are able to do above what I think, it means I'm overflowing. I'm full, but God is making me to overflow. So what are you saying?
I'm empty.
This is the time that you establish a right thought. If you believe, shout
hallelujah.
You can't defeat a Christian who have got thoughts of Christ. You can't defeat that Christian. Deal with your thoughts. If you want to hear from God, start to channel your thoughts. Carry on believing that God is going to make a way. Are you hearing me? Don't change. Don't say this tomorrow, you say that. If you want something, stand on it. Pray over it. Give thanks over it. Think about it. Meditate about it. And the word of God will be established in your life. And what has been said will come to pass. If you believe, say
amen.
Philippians 4 verse 8. Can you think, as a child of God, you are the head, you are not the tail. I say, you are the head, you are not the tail. Sometimes look at the people you are working with and tell yourself that you are above these people. And you think of those things. And God will do it. If you believe, say
amen.
Think about yourself moving from the house you are staying in.